checked and rechecked everything. I think the signal interceptor's ready to go. Are you?
Let's do this.
All right. Head up onto the platform and we'll see if I can find a signal to lock onto. You wanted to get into the Institute, right? Well, what are you waiting for? Let's see. Relays dialed in. Beam emitters warmed up. Everything looks green. Let me start scanning for the signal. Cross your fingers. I'm inputting the code now. Wow, there's a heck of a lot of interference and ghosting. It's gonna take a minute or two to lock in. By the way, this little trip you're taking is a heck of an opportunity to find out as much as we can about the Institute and what they're up to. I put a clever little program on this holotape that'll scan their network and download anything it finds. If you place it in any terminal down there, it'll do the rest. Bring it back to me and I'll see if I can make sense of whatever it found. Well, well, looks like we have a winner. RF wave capture complete. Ramping the emitter. 60%, 80%. Emitter spiking but steady. All that's left is to throw the transmit switch. Transmitting in 3, 2, 1. Stay safe, soldier.
Face to face. Please, step into the elevator.
Useless.
I can only imagine what you've heard, what you think of us. I'd like to show you that you may have the wrong impression. Welcome to the Institute. This is the reality of the Institute. This place, these people, the work we do. For over 100 years, we've dedicated ourselves to humanity's survival. Decades of research, countless experiments and trials, a shared vision of how science can help shape the future. It has never been easy. And our actions are often misinterpreted by those above ground. Someday, perhaps, we can show them what we've accomplished. But for now, we must remain underground. There's too much at stake here to risk it all. As you've seen, things above are unstable. I'd like to talk to you about what we can do for everyone. But that can wait. You are here for a specific, very personal reason. You are here for your son.
Mm-hmm.
can't pick this. No way to pick this. Don't have the key. Sean?
Huh? Yes, I'm Sean.
Sean? Is that really you?
Who are you?
Sean, it's me. I'm your dad.
Father, what's going on? What's happening?
Sean, are you okay? You're not hurt, are you?
What's going on? Father? Father!
What do you want me to do, Sean? What can I do?
I don't know you. Go away! Father! Father, help me! There's someone here! Help me!
Please, Sean! I'm your father! Talk to me! Just open the door!
Father? Father, help me! He's trying to take me! Father? Father, help me!
S-923 on the recall code Cirrus. Fascinating, but disappointing. The child's responses were not at all what I anticipated. He's a prototype, you understand. We're only just now beginning to explore the effects of extreme emotional stimuli. Please try and keep an open mind. I recognize that you are emotional, and that your journey here has been fraught with challenges. Let's start anew. I am Father. Welcome to the Institute.
Father? That's your name? Your title?
Father is my unofficial title. It's what I've come to mean to the people of the Institute, just as you mean to your son, to Sean.
Just help me understand what's going on here.
I promised answers, and answers you shall have. But I need you to realize that this situation is far more complicated than you could have imagined. You have traveled very far, and suffered a great deal to find your son. Well, your tenacity and dedication have been it's good to finally meet you, after all this time. It's me. I am Sean. I am your son.
How is that even possible?
I know this is a lot to take in. In the vault, you had no concept of the passage of time. You were released from your pod and went searching for the son you'd lost. But then you learned that your son was no longer an infant, but a 10-year-old boy. You believed that 10 years had passed. Is it really so hard to accept that it was not 10, but 60 years? That is the reality. And here I am, raised by the Institute, and now its leader.
But why? Why take a child? Why take you?
Ah, now that's the question, isn't it? Why me? At that time, the year 2227, the Institute had made great strides in synth production. But it was never enough. Scientific curiosity and the goal of perfection drove them ever onward. What they wanted was the perfect machine. So they followed the best example thus far. The human being. Walking, talking, fully articulate, capable of anything.
So the weird science experiments needed specimens. That's why they took you.
In a manner of speaking, yes. The Institute endeavored to create synthetic organics. The most logical starting point, of course, was human DNA. Plenty of that was available, of course. But it had all become corrupted. In this wasteland, radiation affected everyone. Even in their attempts to shield themselves from the world above, members of the Institute had been exposed. Another source was necessary. But then the Institute found me, after discovering records from Vault 111. An infant, frozen in time, protected from the radiation-induced mutations that had crept into every other human cell in the Commonwealth. I was exactly what they needed. And so it was my DNA that became the basis of the synthetic organics used to create every human-like synth you see today. I am their father. Through science, we are family. The synths, me, and you.
Sean. It's really you.
It really is. I know you must have questions. Please. Anything I can do to help you understand.
Kellogg, he worked for you?
Kellogg. He was an Institute asset long before I arrived here. It wasn't until I became director that I learned of all the things he'd done. What kind of man he was.
was a psychopath, but you used him anyway?
Would you have preferred that I turned him loose on the Commonwealth? At least keeping him on a short leash kept the collateral damage to a minimum. The Institute took advantage of Kellogg's vicious nature. I will freely admit that. Institute technology prolonged his life and his usefulness far beyond any normal human lifespan. He never failed the Institute, but his cruelty became more apparent with every completed objective. I won't lie. It's no coincidence your path crossed his. It seemed a fitting way to allow you, us, to have some amount of revenge. What else can I say to ease your mind?
Your mother. She never got to see you grow up.
Yes. What happened to her was... I've gone over the records of the incident, of course. It seems her death was an unfortunate bit of collateral damage.
You don't remember. You didn't see it the way I did. It was brutal.
Yes, I'm sure it was. Sadly, the world has become a brutal, unforgiving place. For many years, I never questioned who my parents were. I accepted my situation, and that was that. With old age comes regret, and asking what if more often. But what matters now is that you and I have a chance to begin again. What else can I say to ease your mind?
So you're in charge of the Institute?
I am the acting director, yes. I spent decades working to reach this point. It's a responsibility I take very seriously. The Institute. It's important. It really is humanity's best hope for the future, no matter what those above ground might think of us.
Sean. It's rough up there, to say the least.
Oh, we've tried that. Surprised? The Institute once tried to help create a stabilized Commonwealth government. It ended in bickering, infighting. It was a disaster. No. We look after our own now. Ultimately, the Commonwealth has nothing to fear from us. Whatever you've seen or heard, I know I can convince you of that. Just give me time. I know there's more for us to discuss, but the Institute is on the verge of some important breakthroughs. Your presence would be appreciated as we approach them. I've been a part of something amazing here. I've helped to build a life for myself and the people of the Institute. And now, after all these years, you have an opportunity to help with that. Doesn't that intrigue you? Isn't that what you want?
Yes, that's what I want.
I know. I know you've been through so much. I'm pleased to see it has not impaired your judgment. Forgive me. I'd assume that after everything I'm sure you've seen above ground, you would be more than a bit biased against us. There is much to be done. You'll need time to acclimate yourself, a chance to become acquainted with our procedures.
I'll do whatever it takes. It's worth it.
I am glad to hear that. The Institute is now your home as much as it is mine. Please take some time, get to know it. Meet the people you'll be working with. You'll want to introduce yourself to the division heads. Dr. Fillmore in Facilities, Dr. Ayo in SRB, Dr. Holdren in Bioscience, and finally Dr. Lee in Advanced Systems. They've all been notified of your arrival, of course. Meet them, and then we'll discuss what comes next.
Mm-hmm.
nice. Doctor.
Oh, they weren't kidding.
I don't know.
You really are.
Most
here.
Of them have lasted
well,
long
right.
past their projected lifespans.
I'm Allie. Allie Fillmore.
You ask me.
You can think of me as the Institute's
well.
Chief engineer. When Father told us about you, I could hardly believe it. You've been through so much, I think most people would have just given up. If you don't mind my asking, what was it that kept you going all that time?
I just wanted to find my son and keep him safe.
Now that you've found him, I hope you're proud of the great man he grew up to be. Now, I'll give you a quick rundown of the facilities division, and then I'll answer any questions you might have afterward. As you might guess, we keep the Institute's mechanical and electrical systems running smoothly. We maintain and upgrade all of the systems that make it possible to live and work in a place like this. There's a lot of machinery behind these walls that recycles the air and water and provides power to the laboratories and quarters. The work we do might not be as exciting as some of the other departments, but it's at least as important. So, now that you're here and you've spoken to Father, does that mean you're on board?
Absolutely.
Oh, good to hear. It'll be a load off Sean's mind. Take your time. Get yourself acquainted. There's a lot to take in. Plenty of things you won't find topside. If there's anything else you'd like to know about the facilities division, I'm happy to discuss it.
It must be a challenge to meet the power demands of a place like this.
Absolutely. We scratch and scrape for every precious ounce of voltage that we can. Over the years, we've learned a few tricks that help supplement our power budget. When necessary, we can tap into select sources on the surface. We take only what we need, of course. Fortunately, Advanced Systems is always working on new solutions to generate more energy. It's a good thing, too, because the demand is always increasing. You don't even want to know what a single use of the molecular dematerializer consumes.
I can't argue with that. Even so, I'm ready to see the full Gen 3.
There we go. All set. Unit neutralized.
No visible reaction to the K-14 compound. We'll start the next trial. The dosage will be much larger this time, and the side effects will likely be more.
Will there be any pain?
Terminal's got this locked.
I suppose it's good.
Then.
them?
The Institute's a big place. It might take a while to learn where everything is.
She's just doing it for fun.
Dr. Lee.
Oh, it's you. You're not authorized to be here.
I'm new around here.
You must think I'm some kind of idiot. Father may have given you the keys to the castle, but I still decide who goes in and who goes out of my laboratory. So why don't you just run along and let me get back to work?
Easy. I just want to talk.
About what? You're obviously here for a reason, and you've already spoiled my experiment, so you might as well spit it out.
I've been sent by the Brotherhood of Steel to find you.
You don't beat around the bush, I'll give you that. I knew it was just a matter of time before your people would track me down. I've been looking over my shoulder for almost a decade, waiting for them to send someone like you to kill me.
I'm only here with good intentions. You have my word.
You're giving me your word, even though we just met? Fine. Since Father trusts you, I'm going to give you the benefit of the doubt. I might not agree with everything he says, but I know he'd never allow harm to come my way. Say what you came here to say, and then leave me alone.
Are you happy here?
You'd think being surrounded by cutting-edge laboratory equipment and some of the greatest minds the world's ever known would be enough. Only problem is the lack of transparency. I don't think we get the full story on everything that occurs down here. What does that have to do with why we're talking?
The Brotherhood needs your help, Doctor.
Needs my help? Why? They seem to have everything under control when I left.
The Brotherhood is having problems. We need your help.
I don't see how that's my problem. Tell me something. Why would I possibly want to come crawling back to the Brotherhood? What reason would I have to throw away everything I've accomplished here?
Father trusts me, and so should you.
He trusts you because you're family. I'm not. I can't just take your word for it. I need more than that.
I was just told to get you to come back.
The Brotherhood wants me back, and the best they can do is send a robot that does nothing but follow orders? Sorry, but you're going to have to do a lot better than that.
The Brotherhood has always been straight with you.
I am getting a bit tired of all the secrets around here. Sometimes I feel like Father isn't being straight with me. Like there are things I'm not supposed to know about. I don't like that. But still, how can I turn my back on all of this?
Your work could be instrumental in freeing the Commonwealth.
You really know how to push my buttons, don't you? You know, I never understood why the Institute was so damn selfish. All those innocent people up there, dying. And here I am, surrounded by technology that could make their lives better. Yet we hide down here and insulate ourselves from everything and everyone. It's not right. It's not right. I'll make my way back to the Brotherhood. But I'm going to have to do it on my own. I can't take any chances being seen with you. Tell whoever sent you that they've just regained the services of Dr. Madison Lee. Now, for the sake of keeping up appearances, let me see that Pip-Boy of yours. I've been told to install a coarser chip in it for you. Father's orders. You're to be given full access, with the ability to relay in and out of the Institute at will.
Thank you. I'm I'm sure that'll come in handy.
Given that the relay is the only way to access the Institute, handy is something of an understatement. In case the significance is lost on you, you'll be the only one here with that kind of access. If nothing else, it should demonstrate the amount of trust Father has placed in you. Speaking of, I trust our discussion will remain between the two of us. Now, I need to get back to work, and I'm sure you have other things to do.
Sleep is such a waste of time. I'd rather be designing more efficient plasma emitters. It's really exciting having you here. I can't wait to see what you can do.
Scanning.
Well, subject. You can teleport.
We're all looking forward to working with you.
To knock some heads
You're
together.
Here.
What now?
Glad you made
They're
it.
Dragging their feet on the targeting package upgrades I asked for.
Maybe I should take some courses with me.
Excuse me, Doctor.
Please don't.
So?
There's enough friction as it is between us and pretty much all the other departments.
So, here you are.
Justin Ayo,
Acting Director of the Synth Retention Bureau. I'll be up front with you. We're going to be keeping a close eye on you for the near future. Despite your relation to Father, you're a bit of an unknown quantity. I'm sure you understand. There won't be any issues, will there?
Why? Don't you trust me?
I'll be honest. You're an outsider. The first outsider to be allowed access to the Institute in quite a long time, in fact. There's little precedent for this situation, so it's only natural to take extra precautions, It's nothing personal, I assure you.
Now, Father has asked that I provide you with a brief overview of the Synth Retention Bureau. Our primary responsibility is the recovery of escaped Synths that are hiding among the human population on the surface.
I'm sure it's best for everyone if the Synths remain here.
Certainly. We can't allow sophisticated Institute technology to fall into the wrong hands.
The results could be disastrous.
Our main instrument is the Courser, a third-generation synth assigned to operate on the surface. Coursers hunt down and reclaim synths that have escaped the Institute. They are highly self-sufficient, trained in combat, infiltration, and tracking. In a word, our Coursers are relentless. But I gather you know all this, since you've encountered one already. In fact, I'd very much like to know how you defeated it.
I'm no stranger to combat.
Even so, a courser should be more than a match for any single combatant. I suppose I'll have to ask robotics to perform detailed diagnostics on the entire production run. As if we don't have enough problems. Now, unless you need something else, I'll get back to work.
I'd like to know more about the synth reclamation process.
Fine. Once a courser has located a rogue synth, it uses that synth's recall code to wipe its memories and render it inert. We then begin the delicate process of restoring the neural pathways to their original configuration. In those cases where the procedure is successful, the synth returns to duty with no memory of its time on the surface. All too often, we're unable to repair the damage and are forced to dispose of the unit entirely.
Did I turn off the interferometer?
System nominal.
Got it.
This synth generation is just amazing. Those guys in robotics are working miracles.
Doc.
Welcome. So good to have you here. Dr. Clayton Holdren, head of the Bioscience Division. I can't wait for you to see the work we're doing. It's truly amazing.
I look forward to learning more about it.
In that case, let me give you a brief overview of what we do here. As the name implies, the Bioscience Division specializes in fields of study such as botany, genetics, and medicine. Our most important directive is to ensure the health and well-being of everyone in the Institute. To that end, we cultivate highly specialized breeds of flora for use in food and medicine. We've even started to explore the idea of synthetic animal life. You probably saw the gorillas. They're really just a pet project at this point, but the potential is exciting nonetheless.
Seems like there's nothing you guys can't do.
With hard work and ingenuity, any challenge can be overcome. I'm sure I've taken up enough of your time as it is. But I have to ask, have you decided whether you'll join us?
I'm not sure how well I'll fit in, but I'd like to give it a try.
Great. I was hoping you'd say that. In any case, I imagine you'll want to continue looking around. Or, if you prefer, I'd be happy to answer any questions you might have.
Is there anything I can do to help out?
There might be. Tell you what, you get settled in and check back with me later. I'll see what I can find out. Holdren's Synth Gorilla Project is showing promising results.
Father is more than just our leader. He is our creator.
Now that you've had a chance to see the Institute firsthand, what do you think?
First things first, how do I get back to the surface?
The same way you got in, of course. You are not a prisoner here. You may come and go as you please. Ultimately, all our knowledge and resources are focused on a single goal. The goal is best summarized by our motto: Mankind Redefined. Unfortunately, no advancement comes without occasional setbacks. As remarkable as our synths are, they can be dangerous without proper supervision. The superior synth mind and body attempting to wrestle with something approaching free will can be a recipe for chaos.
If the synths are intelligent and self-aware, then they have a right to free will.
However closely they may approximate human behavior, they are still our creations. When you see what I have to show you, I think you'll agree that we know what is best for our synths. A rogue synth has taken over the Raider gang at Libertalia. His memories have been erased, and his identity altered. He believes he's a man named Gabriel. Under his leadership, the Raiders have taken many innocent lives. I've dispatched a courser to Libertalia. I'd like you to join him and reclaim that synth.
We'll bring that synth home.
That would be best for everyone. Now you should get moving. Many people are in danger, and a delay could cost lives.
What the Interceptor would do to you.
I wasn't worried. After all, I built the device myself.
I have confidence in everything I built, too. But that's because I'll only deal with technology that I understand. Speaking of technology I don't understand, I'll get this holotape to Proctor Quinlan. I'm dying to find out what's on it.
So we were just shooting in the dark?
It was the best we could come up with on such short notice. Before we jump to conclusions, let's see what Quinlan's scribes can get off of it. I'm sure the Institute has all of their data heavily encrypted, so it's gonna take some time to crack. After that, we'll have to see what we've got. There's no telling what we might have grabbed off their mainframe. In the meantime, your mission to recruit Dr. Lee still needs to be completed. I believe Elder Maxson gave you all of the details? Good luck, Knight.
Folks. receive word that Dr. Lee is returning to us. How cooperative do you think she'll be?
I've convinced her that the Institute is the enemy, not the Brotherhood.
Well done, Knight. As soon as Dr. Lee arrives, we'll interrogate her aboard the Pridwin. She's been under the Institute's influence for the last decade, and we can't afford to take any chances. Now, on to other matters. Thanks to the success of your reconnaissance efforts, it's time to advance our operations to the next phase. I want you to report to Proctor Ingram at the airport. She has a special project that requires your immediate attention. Once again, Knight, you don't fail to impress. Dismissed.
I bet you're eager to get your hands dirty on our new project. How much has Maxon told you about it?
Whatever it is, I'm sure it'll help us crush the Institute.
It will, but we've got a lot of work ahead of us first. Come on, it's this way. Unless you're blind as a bat, I'm sure you've noticed that we've been building a gantry on the tarmac. Maxon and Kells have been looking for something that'll tip the balance when we go toe-to-toe with the Institute. Now, the Pridwin might be a big beast, but she's not built for fighting. That's where our new project comes in. This storage bay full of parts is what's left of Liberty Prime. The Brotherhood used it in the Capital Wasteland as a weapon against the Enclave. It's the most advanced robot the Brotherhood has ever had at its disposal. Unfortunately, Liberty Prime was destroyed in the line of duty. I've spent the better part of the last few years piecing him back together. And if you think that was easy, try rebuilding a Protectron while you're blindfolded. In order to get Liberty Prime fully operational, we're going to need your help.
No problem. I'm sure this only looks worse than it actually is.
I wish I had your confidence, because this is not going to be easy. Now, the good news is that we've got most of Prime's parts fully assembled. The bad news is that it's going to take more than a few rivets and some spot welding to get them working again. The first problem is his CPU. It's fragile, and every time we try to feed power to it, it blows itself out.
Why is the power blowing out his CPU?
Liberty Prime has a highly complex power system. A good deal of that system was damaged when he exploded. So I'm working in the dark trying to come up with parts on my own. Luckily, you were able to convince Dr. Madison Lee to return to the Brotherhood. She was on the original build team for Liberty Prime a little over a decade ago. I've already spoken to her, but she's reluctant to work on Prime for some reason. If you could get her down here to lend a hand with his power system, we can get the big guy moving.
Thank you. Attention all personnel. Research patrols are a crucial facet of our operation here in the Commonwealth. Any Brotherhood soldiers that have not received a research patrol assignment should speak
if
to Proctor Quinlan immediately.
To working on Liberty Prime, you can forget it.
You promised you'd help us.
You're right, I did. But you neglected to mention that I'd be asked to work on Liberty Prime. I've been down this road with the Brotherhood before. Why would I make the same mistake twice?
Because we care what happens to the Commonwealth.
You may not like the Brotherhood, but the people of the Commonwealth shouldn't have to suffer for it.
You know, if anyone else wearing a Brotherhood of Steel uniform said something like that, I'd laugh in their face. But coming from you, it sounds like you actually mean it. Tell Proctor Ingram to get her scribes ready. It's going to take a hell of a lot of work to get Liberty Prime back online, but we'll get it done.
To a good start? Isn't that right, Doctor?
I hope so. Prime suffered some significant damage to his memory core. I wish your people would have been a bit more careful, Proctor. The good news is that the damage isn't irreversible, and I should be able to get the power flowing into his CPU core without overloading. If your people stay out of my way, that is.
Charming, isn't she?
Asking her to help.
Nah, don't worry about it. We might not be best buddies, but we'll get the job done. Besides, Dr. Lee's worth all the aggravation. We're working with one of Prime's original designers. I don't see it getting any better than that. In fact, since things are going so well, we're gonna have you start building his electromagnetic actuators.
Sure, anything you need.
That's what I love about you. You're ready to leap into action, and I bet you don't have the faintest idea what I'm talking about. The actuators are what allows Liberty Prime's arms and legs to move. Prime's new limbs are way too heavy for the simple hydraulic pistons he had in the past. We're gonna have to rip those out, construct a brand new system using electromagnets, and install them in his limbs. What we need you to do is build the actuators for us.
Now that you know what the actuators are, you need to know how to make them. These are the plans and the materials list. Don't lose them.
Now, before you get that look on your face, you'll be happy to know that we have plenty of the raw materials on that list right here at the airport. The only thing we need you to head out and find is a high-powered magnet. According to Proctor Quinlan, the best place to find one is in any of the ruined hospitals around the Commonwealth. We've already sent out a few teams to find the rest of the high-powered magnets you'll need. They should be back by the time you return.
Once you start building the actuators, we need one for each limb, so you'll need to make a total of four. Good luck.